It is new release time, Dynamics 365 sales. Let's take a look at what's coming up here. It's, of course, all about Copilot. I'm going to do something a little bit different than what I normally do here. Instead of trying to rank the features, I'm actually going to go through them in what is a logical order. Give each one a rating. Let me know what you think in the comments. There are two main parts to this, and it is all about Copilot. There's actually only two features in the main Dynamics 365 sales release notes that aren't Copilot features, and they were both in the Wave 1 release pushed out. So we're just going to move on past that, focus on these things, because this is absolutely clearly the direction working with this app. First part here, Copilot in Dynamics 365 Sales. These are the experiences that are part of that app. There are some experiences in Outlook and Teams, but all of these new features really focus on those things. And that's the part that's included in your Dynamics 365 Sales Enterprise License. Then we're going to move on and have a look at the features that are in the Microsoft Copilot for Sales. That's the license that also includes Copilot for Microsoft 365. So we're starting to get into combined experiences of CRM with Outlook, OneNote, stay tuned for that one, that are going to kind of change the way that we can think about what CRM is. But two different licenses, and I'm going to go through those in those sections. So first up here, the immersive homepage. We've seen bits and pieces of this coming through before. I think this actually got a mention earlier. This really changes the experience of CRM. You come into Dynamics and this is what you get. Apologies for the slightly blurry image. We only get low quality images in preview stages. But instead of a dashboard, which is what we're used to, you've got this immersive experience. It's giving you these cards. You can see here we've got suggested actions, some sort of chart showing you what's going on. Here are my opportunities. Here are the latest updates. So it's starting to aggregate all these things. And then that experience at the bottom where you're querying in natural language. This is going to really challenge people to rethink, do I need a dashboard when I start off versus this immersive dynamic kind of screen? So this is a very exciting space to watch. I'm giving this one 5 stars here because this just changes the very nature of thinking about what CRM and reporting can be about. Next up, we have the idea of an account 360. This one actually was also pushed out from the Wave 1 release, but I think it's important enough to give a mention to here. The idea of this panel on the side giving you summaries. So when we work with Dynamics 365, there's always a lot of thought and consideration in how we're doing the screen layout and putting the right things on the screen in the right place. When you're working with an account and you've got a lot of rolled up information, if you're in a B2B scenario, your account has a lot of things related to it. What are all the related cases, the related opportunities, the related contacts? And typically that ends up being in a lot of tabs on the form. I'm loving this sort of piece down the side here that gives you a summary with some visuals and allows you to get to that in a way that's much less about forms over data. I'm giving this one 3 stars. It doesn't kind of completely change the world, but I think it's going to make that navigation easier to get to the key information that sellers would want to see rather than having to tab around a lot. We all love next best action suggestions. This is something that people always ask for when we're talking with Dynamics 365 sales, CRM stuff. I want to be able to have my CRM suggest the next actions here. We've had features like this before, but I think the way that this AI is going now, there is so much more potential in this being something more useful than the sort of the old cards that we used to have that popped up that largely had to be configured by an automated workflow that we can genuinely start to use AI here. I've seen some of these things come through. So there are some ideas around in that side panel on Dynamics, you'll have something that says, show me my emails that need follow up and anything in your inbox that hasn't been answered in the last 3 to 8 days shows there. I think that stuff is really useful, that blending of those experiences. There's a lot coming here, which we will get to around CRM working with meetings more seamlessly. So this idea of the action suggestions popping up in line to help you keep things up to date, to help you pick up on those other things. No seller ever likes doing the data entry. Every sales manager ever feels the pain of the sellers not doing the data entry. So these things really help. I'm giving this one 4 stars because we love the next best action suggestions. Document summary. This one, I think this could be big. We have Inside the CRM, you can store related documents. So you can have, here's my account and my opportunity with the documents that are related to that. But no one's ever kind of going in and clicking through and finding things in there. People will ask about this. You could, because it's stored on SharePoint, you could kind of go and do a SharePoint search, but it's taking you out of the experience. This idea of being able to say, give me a summary of the documents associated with this, especially if you're in a team selling environment where multiple people have added documents or you've added something and passed it on to someone else, but to go in there straight away and sort of say, what do I need to understand as a seller from what's in those documents? Hopefully, look, I'm nervous giving things a rating. You'll see the things that don't have screenshots here are the things that all I've got to go on is what's in the written description. So I'm taking a punt. Let's hope I'm right. I'm hoping this one is going to be 5 stars. Don't forget to give this video a like. Subscribe to the channel if you like these updates. I do enjoy doing these videos and I'm told you enjoy watching them. So I'm going to keep going here. The next section here is around the Copilot for Sales. So we're in a different license now. This one is going to cost you more, but it's important to understand where this is going because this is where most of the work and most of the innovation is. And there are some very cool things happening here. First one here, I'm really interested to hear what you might think about this. Manage customer objections in real time. So the idea here is that I think especially if you've got newer sellers or if you've got a scenario perhaps where you're working at volume rather than sort of that relationship longer term based sale where you've got people in a call center and making lots of calls, this is something where in real time in the Teams meeting, it's going to come up with these suggestions around tracking from the transcript where a customer has made an objection, tracking the sentiment, offering coaching tips. I think, you know, back we used to have a thing that was conversation intelligence that was doing some of this inside the app. Again, like the cards that are suggesting the next best actions, this stuff has really moved forward now with the AI technology underneath. I'm a little jury out on this one. I'm not sure. I don't work as much perhaps with customers who are doing this sort of very call center type selling. But if you are in that scenario, how do you reckon this one will go? Let's watch this preview in October and see what's going to happen here. However, this one. Back to my point around no seller ever wants to update meeting notes, write notes in the CRM, and everyone I talk to wants that stuff in their CRM. These features that automatically do that for you. We love these features. So if you are working with, obviously this is Teams meetings, if you're doing meetings, you know, that way and you're keeping the transcript and all of those things, this is now taking that information, but it's overlaying a sales piece to it. So you might have seen the Teams meeting summaries if you're working with that Copilot in Microsoft 365 in Teams, but now we're getting this AI generated meeting summary, but connected back to the CRM and offering specific suggestions. I've started to see this come through in Outlook where it will say, based on the email, you should update the opportunity date, close date to this, or update the budget to that. So it looks like we're getting that kind of prompt out of a meeting as well. I love this idea. I hope this is everything that's promised, because the idea of being able to say, I finished my meeting, how good would it be to not have to go and do the admin of updating all of that stuff in the CRM afterwards? It's going to go, yep, the person mentioned this change to the budget and this change to that, and it's good to go. And on the same thing, if you've watched me before, you know I always put a 2-for-1 in here, don't you? So this is 7A and B here. We have got the ability to create opportunities from a meeting summary. So if you've done an initial call and then you want to create that opportunity for the first time, you'll be able to do that from in context of the Teams recap and create follow-up emails from the meeting summary where the seller is prompted to send a draft. Thank you and next steps. And here's the draft of the email with the summary and the action items. Love this one. I'm giving this one 4 stars. I think these things are kind of, look, I don't know the difference between 5 and 4 on this. Maybe on average, those three features come out at around a 4.5. It's not an exact science. This one is really interesting. Sales playbooks. Now, as far as I know, this is, well, as far as I can piece together, because there's very little information about this one. This is preview in November. So watch this space. We'll see what happens here. But this doesn't appear to be, there were playbooks in Dynamics 365 sales that have been deprecated. And the way this is phrased is that the sales manager uploads a playbook. So I think this is going to be something different, but we don't have that information yet. But the idea of saying there is some kind of playbook that the manager, the sales manager, is putting together, that we want to hit these steps in the sales conversation, and then the Copilot can monitor how the seller is doing against that, and the seller will get real-time signals about how they're doing. I'm giving this 3 stars. I can't really tell yet if it's going to be amazing or not, or we need to see more. So let's see what comes for that one. This one is really cool. This is a screenshot of what it is now, but we don't have a screenshot of what's going to happen. But the contact insights in Outlook looks something like this at the moment. But this feature is around enhancing that and adding more things in here. So that idea of the Copilot inside Outlook giving you more suggestions to say, do you want to look at a recent meeting? Do you want to look at a recent email? Do you want to see the three most recent emails? Here's an AI-based summary of those things. So this is in a zone of stuff that's similar to what's already there, but really being enhanced. 4 stars because I love this feature and enhancing it. Thank you. Let's please do that. I've saved the best till last here. Don't run away. And don't, if you see OneNote on the screen here, don't write this off. This is important. What I find when I'm talking to people who are in, especially, you know, B2B or relationship sellers, there's a lot of detail that people need to capture, the seller needs to capture during that call or during the process. A lot of people use OneNote for this because the CRM notes are very small, and, you know, that's great for a quick note in the timeline. I know I actually work in a sales related job and I've got copious amounts of stuff in OneNote. I use this all the time. And so this has always been a bit of a tricky story. How do we combine these things? Because OneNote sort of exists quite separately from the CRM. I'm giving this one 5 stars because I think this is genuinely important if it is what it promises to be. The picture on the screen is showing you a current feature. If you've got the Copilot for Microsoft 365, check this one out. You can actually, if you've got meeting notes or a transcript or something inside of OneNote, you can actually right click on it and say summarize or create a to-do list. And it actually does a pretty good job of that. This feature in the new release here is about saying that you can summarize your notes in OneNote using this skill and save it to CRM. I'm loving this. I will definitely be doing a video on this when this comes out. In the meantime, though, check out the Power Platform release notes. There's a bunch of stuff in there you're going to want to keep up with as well. Thank you for watching.